Now it's primary biliary cirrhosis, and this is one of the cause for chronic liver disease. Now in this you can find the features and signs for chronic liver disease. As I have explained before, some of the signs, more of the signs, some signs overlap. Depends upon what your patient, what you got in the exam, your patient is having. And the command can be same as I told in chronic liver disease. Okay, the same command can be. So you will find chronic liver disease. But when you will say that it is primary biliary cirrhosis, like the cause for chronic liver disease is primary biliary cirrhosis. Because when we are presenting to the examiner, when we are telling them this is a chronic liver disease, then sometime when cause is obvious, some features are obvious for chronic liver, the cause for chronic liver disease, then examiner can ask, okay, what do you think, what could be the cause? So when you will say that this chronic liver disease is due to primary biliary cirrhosis, there are certain features like all signs of chronic liver disease, this you will find. In addition, you can find generalized pigmentation, and it is due to melanin deposition rather than jaundice. There could be jaundice in primary biliary cirrhosis, but this is a late feature. So you will find a generalized pigmented patient, okay, and you can see the xanthelasmas on the face. You can feel the tendons and xanthomas along the elbows, mostly in the forearms, and also you can find the excoriation marks. So these are the features. And in abdomen, usually in the, what happens in the cirrhosis, the liver is shrunken. There is no hepatomegaly in cirrhosis, okay, but in primary biliary cirrhosis there is hepatomegaly. Actually there are three causes of cirrhosis in which instead of shrunken liver there is hepatomegaly, and it is alcoholic liver disease, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and primary biliary cirrhosis. Okay, so please remember it. And along with it, on inspection you may find kyphosis, because in this actually the metabolism for the fat soluble vitamins, this is disturbed. So vitamin D is also fat soluble vitamin, and because of that patients can have osteoporosis, osteomalacia. So there can be kyphosis and proximal muscle weakness. These are the features. Plus, in addition, because this is an autoimmune disease, so you may find some features for the other autoimmune disease. There are many autoimmune diseases you can find. Just few I will mention, and just keep your inspection very sharp so that if it is there, so you can pick. Because if it is very much evident, then examiner can ask, and if you will tell, then you will get very good marks. Okay, like you can see the white patches for vitiligo, okay, and you can see ptosis in case if it is associated with myasthenia gravis. Okay, then you can find arthropathic hands like rheumatoid arthritis and these features, and then the facial features for scleroderma even you can find. So is it clear? Like it will present like chronic liver disease, its commands will be same like chronic liver disease. In addition, these are the features which I just now explained. You will say that the cause could be primary biliary cirrhosis. Okay, now there are few things I want to tell you, that there could be anemia in primary biliary cirrhosis or in chronic liver disease. There are many causes. It could be either due to GI blood loss, due to esophageal varices or peptic ulcer, or it could be due to other autoimmune disorder underlying, like pernicious anemia, celiac disease, atrophic gastritis. Okay, because if examiner asks, then you should know what are the causes for anemia in primary biliary cirrhosis. Okay, xanthelasma, you can see this is an important feature, and again it signifies hypercholesterolemia, as we all know, right? And pruritus can occur even in the absence of advanced liver disease, and you can find the scratch marks. And kyphosis, old fractures, proximal myopathy, and features of underlying disease, features of any underlying autoimmune disease. So these are the features from of the primary biliary cirrhosis. I hope that now it is clear to you and it's not difficult for you to identify, and you can get features of primary biliary cirrhosis with hepatomegaly, with splenomegaly, with hepatosplenomegaly, with ascites, without ascites, with gynecomastia, with spider-nevi, with clubbing. Like, there could be overlapping features for the chronic liver disease, so you have to identify that patient is having chronic liver disease but the underlying cause is primary biliary cirrhosis. Okay, so how you will diagnose? The same investigations for chronic liver disease as I explained, you will tell. Plus, you will say that on liver function test there will be raised alkaline phosphatase and serum anti-mitochondrial antibody. This is 95% positive. Okay, and ultrasound ERCP or MRCP, it is often performed to exclude extrahepatic cholestasis. So the all the investigations of chronic liver disease plus these investigations you have to tell. Okay, so now how you will manage? Again, you will explain that your management includes journal and specific. Journal is always journal, as I have explained in chronic liver disease, the same way. And specific management includes supplementation of the fat soluble vitamins like A, D, E and K. It should be supplemented, okay? So because there is disturbance because of deficiency of vitamin D, there could be osteomalacia and in turn osteoporosis, and because of vitamin K deficiency there could be coagulopathy. Patient can get bruise. Then sir, I will supplement fat soluble vitamins to combat like A, D, E and K. I will treat the bone disease like osteoporosis and osteomalacia with vitamin D, calcium and bisphosphonate, and I will treat hypercholesterolemia with statin, and treatment for the liver disease with also deoxycholic acid, and management of pruritus with, there are three drugs actually, cholestyramine, rifampicin and naltrexone. Okay, cholestyramine, rifampicin and naltrexone. First you will give first one, if it doesn't, patient doesn't improve, then second, then third you will give. Okay, and there could be associated fatigue along with it, and you should identify why patient is having fatigue, and for that you can give, of course depending upon the cause, but naltrexone is of some benefit. And fatigue could be due to any associated autoimmune disorder like hypothyroidism, myasthenia gravis, or due to depression. And such patients are also prone for transplantation. And what is criteria for transplantation? When serum bilirubin is more than 50 micromole per liter, or there is refractory fatigue or pruritus, then these patients are referred for transplant. Okay, so I think this is clear to you.
Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.